Hey guys, how you doing? Right here again. If you'd like to subscribe, it's Nitro Kyosho. Remember to follow me on Facebook, guys. Nitro Kyosho, all one word, brings you to the community page. This is just going to be a quick little video, guys. This is just going to be a little crash kit that I kind of put together. Some of the stuff that I feel it would need, and it's not a bad idea to have a little bit of a kit ready. I'm going to be using this thing a lot more than my bigger machines. I love practicing and putting the wear and tear on the cheaper machines. Let's get started and I'll show you what I got. Now, it would be nice if we were a fortune teller, you know, guys, and knew what exactly was going to happen when these things hit the ground. And the situations can all be different. But some of the stuff that I got here was a boom. Now everyone says these booms detach and, you know, everyone's opinion. I've always seen them get destroyed, wrecked, broken, cracked, whatever, so I got a boom. Alright, that's one thing. Canopy. I got a replacement canopy for this guy. That's something that you really don't want to be flying around with all taped up and cracked and beat up, because that really, the main purpose of the canopy is to protect the internals of the machine, guys. So definitely have a good clean canopy on there when running it, not one that's all beat up and cracked, because the next crash could do something worse. I've seen these things a lot of time, the stock BK servo horns like to break very easy, which is a good thing. I'm not a big fan of metal. Every situation I've ever seen with metal usually will strip the servo because the arm doesn't give. So I like plastic. I got the SAB ones here, the replacement ones. Ball links can break too. Those are good to have, a few of them. And an extra skid, and I have also a set of the Zeal blades here. So, I mean, I've gotten stuck in the past, guys, with overbuying and then selling. I'm in a situation right now. I'm selling my T-Rex 450L Dominator to a good friend, and I've got a bazillion extra parts for it. So. You know, I'm an impatient guy. I don't like to wait. Every time I have an accident or something, then you go to buy a part, and then that one part you need is sold out. So, anyways, these are just a few of the things that I got. And probably one of the first questions I'm going to ask is no shafts. The shafts on these machines, for some reason, are very, very strong. And that's a good thing. And hopefully they don't change that. The spindle shaft, the main shaft on this guy, and the tail. I've seen a 500 completely annihilated, and none of the shafts bent. So I didn't bother to get any shafts for it. So just a couple of little things, guys, just to get the thing looking back presentable. The tail blades usually don't break. The plastic ones are pretty flexible. You know, and you obviously don't want to go stocking up on spare servos and expensive things like that. But from my experiences and the things I've seen in the past on different models, and hopefully you don't have a bad crash. Nobody wants to have a bad crash where you get frame damage or anything like that. But canopy, main blades, boom, a set of skids, servo horns break, ball links. And for me, that's about all I'm going to get at this point, just to have on hand. One thing I want to touch on, guys, quickly. I had a subscriber kind of get all riled up with me because he apparently had been watching my channel for a while. And he saw the video I put out about this, the Goblin 380 versus the Dominator, which flew better, and I said this did, and he didn't like that because apparently he went out over the winter and bought 5 T-Rex helicopters. I try to tell him there's nothing wrong with T-Rex helicopters. I got one back here and I love it, okay, 700. And I think the level that he's at, he's not going to pick up a Goblin and notice the difference. And the other big thing is I would not have wanted to learn with a Goblin. They're very expensive to fix, and is not something you'd want to be beating up. Okay, so I don't think you made a bad decision, guy, by buying all those T-Rex helicopters. I think you're going to love them, and I think you're going to have a lot of fun and a lot of success with them. So I wouldn't think that was a bad decision that you made. Remember, guys, my opinion is just my opinion. It's not set in stone, okay? The other question that I've been getting asked a lot is, Ray, what happened to the other skids? Well, I had watched two of my videos, one with these set of skids sitting on the table and one with the other set of skids. And if you watch those two videos, you'll see that right here, which I noticed, is the way it's sitting, is this tail is up in the air, okay? And if you put this blade down, you've got, hold on, from where that blade stands, you've got about 2 1/4 inches, guys, of that tail blade up off the ground. For somebody like me that takes off mostly in grass and you don't want to beat up the tail and the tail blades, this is very convenient. Now, when you put the other set of carbon fiber skids on, guys, and you look at it, it sits like this where the tail is down, and now you have the blade about 1/4 to 1/2 inch off of the ground. Even with the battery, it still sat like that. Okay, so I found that the speed design is actually pretty stable. I don't think it's as stable as the other set of skids, but I kind of like the goofy look. I've grown to love it now. And so I'm going to leave it like that for now. Now, if I find that I'm having trouble landing in the future or in thicker grass, that it's kind of unstable, then I might go back and put those back on. But for right now, I'm going to leave these on. So I hope that answers the questions. My other subscriber, Ray, that's all shook up about buying all those T-Rexes. You didn't make a mistake, Ray. They're great helicopters. And, you know, I think you'll have a lot of fun and a lot of success with them. And then you can, when you become a better pilot down the road, you can make decisions on other brands, okay? But when you're learning, you definitely want things that don't cost a lot of money to fix. So that's it, guys. That's my little crash kit here. I wanted to have the Goblin on the table because if I did the crash kit without it on the table, guys would be asking me if I smashed it. No, I didn't. Here it is. Here's the parts. Anyways, thanks for watching, guys. And that's just a little crash kit from HeliDirect.com. And thanks to my friend Long Vu and great customer service.